हेलो गाइस, दिस इज हर्षवर्धन। वेलकम बैक टू माय चैनल हर्ष सीबीएस। इन द प्रीवियस वीडियो वी हैव स्टडीड अबाउट कंप्लीट इंफॉर्मेशन ऑफ ए रिप्रेजेंटेशन ऑफ ए डिस्क्रीट टाइम सिग्नल्स। Now here we will study about a representation of a discrete time systems. Okay. Now, in general, what is a system? System is a device which take input and it performs some transformations and give it as a output. It is known as a system. Okay. System is a device which take input, perform some transformations. And give some output. Okay. See, then what is a discrete time system? Discrete time system is the system defined as a physical device which produces discrete version of output for a discrete time signal. See here. It is a discrete time input. For the discrete time input, what we are getting discrete time of output. Then what system is doing? System is transforming this input signal and it is giving us an output signal. That is the role of the system. So discrete time system means which take a discrete time signal as a input and give discrete time signal as an output. It is called as a discrete time system. Now, discrete time systems are basically mainly classified into 12 types. These are static, dynamic, linear, non-linear, time variant, time invariant, causal, non-causal, stable, unstable, invertible, non-invertible. For our easy convenience, I will divide it into 6 subcategories. First two, static, dynamic as one category, linear, non-linear as one category, time variant, time invariant as one category, causal, non-causal as one category, and finally stable, unstable, invertible, non-invertible. So these are the 6 categories we have divided for our convenience. Now we will discuss everything in detail. Okay. Now what is a static? Static systems are which do not have any memory. If our system have memory, it is called a dynamic system. If our system do not have any memory, it is called a static memory. Okay, or it is called a memoryless. No storage of past and future values. For the calculation of this, try to perform always do this timeline analysis. 0, 1, 2, minus 1, and here. Minus 2. Okay, so always we try to keep as a n values as an integer here. Try to keep n value as 0. We are getting 0. Okay, so for n value here 0, we are getting 0 here. Okay, so for it is not storing any past or future values. What is the future value of 0, 1 or 2? What is past value, minus 1 or minus 2? It is not storing any value, so it is a static system. Now come, here comes the dynamic. Dynamic is a which shows the exact opposite nature of a static. Static is a memoryless, but it is a memory. Static won't store any past and future, but dynamic stores past and future values. Again do. Always do timing analysis such that you won't get confused. Okay. Now see, place n value as 0. We are getting 0. Yes, but it is only static for n equal to 0. For only n equal to 0, it is a static. Okay. But place another value here. If I place n equal to 1 here, we get n equal to 2n means we are getting 2 here. So for 1, we are getting a value of 2. So we are getting future value. So it is a dynamic system. Second one, for n equal to 0, place here 0. If I place 0 here, I get minus 1. For 0, minus 1 is a past value. So it is storing a past value. So it is also a dynamic system. Okay, now linear and non-linear systems. If a system satisfies superposition and homogeneity, it is a linear system. Otherwise, it is a non-linear system. Okay, I will explain with an example such that you will get more clarity. Now, x1 of n as an input signal, we are getting y1 of n as an output. For x2 of n, we are getting y2 of n as an output. For the combined signal x1 of n plus x2 of n, we are getting y3 of n as an output. See, for linear and non-linear system, follow these 5 steps. Assume this as an equation number 1, 2, 3. 3 steps. At the step number 4, perform just addition of equation 1 and 2, such that x1 plus x2, y1 plus y2. Now, this assume this as an equation number 4. At a final step, we need to perform some calculation. See, at final step, just equate equation number 4, equation number 3 right hand terms, y3 of n, y1 plus y2 of n. Just equate both. If this is the equation which is coming, then our system is a linear system. So for our linear system, our equation must and should satisfy this. What is the equation? Y3 of n must and should be equal to y1 of n plus y2 of n. Only in such a case our system is a linear, otherwise it is a non-linear system. Now see this example, you will get more clarity. Okay, for x1 of n, we are getting a output as a y1 of n plus c. For x2 of n, we are getting y2 of n plus c. For a combined signal, we are getting y3 of n plus c. What I have said, only 5 steps. Step number 1, this is step number 2, step number 3. At step number 4, what we have to perform? Just to perform addition. X1 of n, x2 of n, x1 of n, x2 of n, y1 plus y2, y1 plus y2, c plus c, we are getting 2c. Now what we need to do, assume it as a equation number 4. At last step, what we need to perform? Compare equation 3 and 4 right hand sides. What is the right hand side? Y3 of n plus c, y3 of n plus c, okay. Y1 plus Y2 plus 2C, Y1 plus Y2 plus 2C, okay. Now C cancel, C cancel. We are having another C here, right? So is this equation look similar to this? No, there is a extra C here. So our system is a non-linear system, okay. Next coming to very very important time invariant system, where we will do a lot of mistake here only. What is a time invariant system? Time invariant system is also known as a shift invariant systems. What is meant by invariant? If I change my output or input, there should not be any effect on the output. Okay, input and output maintain equal time delays. Such systems are called a time invariant system. See here, x1 of n giving output as a y1 of n. X1 of n minus k, here we are performing shifting by k, such that it is giving as equation y1 of n minus k. The same shift is happening here. Okay. If our system obey this type of property, it is called as a time invariant systems. For the time invariant, we are having only just two steps. First step, delay input by k units, delay output by k samples. Okay, but here remember, for the input you need to delay only k. In the second step, where there is an n, try to keep there n minus k. Okay, come on, see here, wait, Wait, I will show example in the last page. Okay. Now, causal and non-causal systems. What is a causal systems? I will give more clarity for you, such that you won't forget. Okay. See. In our general, this is a causal signal. Okay. See, remember carefully, it is a causal signal, but don't consider it as a causal system. Why? Because signal and system shows a exact opposite nature. It is, I have shown that previous is a causal signal, but these are the causal systems. Okay, see. Now read the definition. Output depends on past and present. These are the past values. Assume it as our 0 as our present. This is a past values and this is a present value. Okay. Then what is a non-causal? Output depends on future values. If our output depends on a future value, it is called as a non-causal. It is called a causal. Okay. See. If I place 0 here, 0 minus 1. So for the 0 minus 1 is a past value. So it is a causal system. Place 0 here, 0, 0, 1. So for the 0, 1 is a future value. So it is called non-causal systems. Okay. Now, stable, unstable. If our system satisfies bounded input, bounded output, then the system is a stable system. If it does not satisfy, it is called an unstable system. Okay. Now, invertible and non-invertible. What is meant by invertible for our system? If there is a inverse, what is meant by inverse? I will explain. Wait. So here we are giving signal x of n. If we, after performing many transformations, if we get our original signal back, it is called invertible system in simple. If our signal is x of n, after perform many transformation, if we are not getting our signal back, it is called a non-invertible signal in a simple manner. Okay. Now, see here. Y1 of n, assume it as a y1 of n. Okay. Y1 of n equal to x of n convolution h of n. Assume this as a P of n. Okay, output of a invertible system called P of n. So what is P of n? Y1 of n convolution with H inverse of n is called P of n. What is a Y1 of n? We have written here X of n convolution H of n. X of n convolution H of n. Convolution with H inverse of n. Now arrange in such a way that H of n is convolved with H inverse of n. So by our standard result, H of n convolution with H inverse of n equal to del of n. So X of n convolution with del of n. Any signal that is convolved with del means delta. Any signal convolved with delta of n equal to X of n. Okay. Okay. Now, see this problem, so you will get more clarity. Y of n equal to minus n plus 1. Okay, see, place here 0. What we are getting? X of 1. So it is storing future values, so it is not a static. So it is a dynamic system. Simple. Now, linearity. What I say, just follow 5 steps. X1 of minus n plus 1 giving y1 of n. Okay, equation 1. X2 of n giving y2 of n. Okay, this combined signal giving 3. At the 4 steps, simply add this. X1 of minus n plus 1, X2 of minus n plus 1 in the 4th step. Y1 of n plus y2 of n. Y1 of n plus y2 of n. This is the 4th step. In the 5th step, what we need to do? We need to check right hand side of 3 and 4. For the equation number 4, we are having y1 of n plus y2 of n. For equation number y3 of n. Yes. It is our required equation? Yes. So it is a linear. Now coming to causal, what I have said here, causal here, non-causal. Okay, now output depends on past and present. Y of 0 equal to y of 1, x of 1. See, for the 0 we are getting 1, such that we are in the region of a non-causal, so it is a non-causal systems. Next, time variant and time invariant. It is a very simple, but here many students will do mistake. Okay, in the remember only two steps. First step, write the same equation, just delay by k, so minus k. This is first step, finish. In the second step, where there is n, replace by n minus k. Where there is n, replace by n minus k. N minus k. Where there is a n, replace by n minus k. Now what we get finally? Minus n plus 1 plus k. Minus n plus 1 minus k. Now compare equation 1 and 2. Are they are same on the right hand side? No. Here minus. Here we are having plus. So these are not time invariant. These will vary with time. So these are called time variant systems. Okay. Now, stable and unstable. For every bounded value, if I keep here 0, 0 is a bounded. What is meant by bounded? Means finite. Okay. If I keep 0 here, I will get 1. If I keep 2, I will get minus 2 plus 1. I will get 1. Okay. For a bounded input, I am getting bounded output. So it is a stable system, definitely. Okay. Now, you practice this question and mention your answers in the comment box, such that I will have a look into the comment box. Okay. Now guys, please like, share, subscribe to my channel. Thank you. I hope you all liked my video. If you really like my video, please share among your friends, such that they will get more benefited. Okay. Thank you.